Hello and welcome to Chanakya IAS Academy. I'm Priya Kumari and today's special current affairs topic is interplay of horizontal and vertical quotas. So before proceeding further, let's see what are the points to ponder upon today. We will see first context, then questions put forward, then Saurav Yadav case, vertical reservation, horizontal reservation, court's judgment, past judgment, government stand and significance. So let's see one by one. So the context behind today's topic is the interlocking of the two types of reservation throws up a host of questions on how certain groups are to be identified. This question came after the December 18 decision by a two-judge bench in Saurav Yadav versus State of UP or Uttar Pradesh dealt with issues arising from the way different classes of reservation were to be applied in the selection process to fill posts of constables in the state. So what were the questions which were put forward? They were: the interlocking of the two types of reservation throws up a host of questions on how certain groups are to be identified. Would an scheduled caste woman be put in the category of woman or scheduled caste category? Since quotas are fixed in percentages, what percentage of quota would be attributed to each? So these were the questions which were put forward. So let's see what is this Saurav Yadav's case. So in this case, Sonam Tomar and Rita Rani, they both secured 276.5949 and 233.1908 marks respectively. They had applied under the categories of OBC female and SC female respectively. The OBC and SC are vertical reservation categories while female is a horizontal reservation category. The two candidates did not qualify in their categories. However, in the general female, which is unreserved female category, the last qualifying candidate had secured 274.8298 marks, a score which were lower than Tomar's, whose marks was 276.5949. The question before the court was that if the underlying criterion for making selections is merit, should Tomar be selected under general female quota instead of OBC female category for having a secured higher score? So we will see what is this vertical reservation. Reservation for scheduled caste, scheduled tribes or other backward classes is referred to as vertical reservation. It applies separately for each of the groups specified under the law. Example, Article 16(4) of the Constitution contemplates vertical reservation. So what is this horizontal reservation? It refers to the equal opportunity provided to other categories of beneficiaries such as women, veteran or elderly, the transgender community and individuals with disabilities cutting through the vertical categories. So example here is Article 15(3). Article 15 Clause 3 of the Constitution contemplates horizontal reservation. The horizontal quota is applied separately to each vertical category and not across the board. That is, horizontal quota is applied in vertical, but vertical is not applied in horizontal. So I hope this much is clear. So example here is, if women have 50% horizontal quota, then half of the selected candidates will have to necessarily be women in each vertical quota category. That is, half of all selected SC candidates will have to be women, half of the unreserved or general category will have to be women, and so on. So what is the court's judgment? The court ruled against the UP government, holding that if a person belonging to an intersection of vertical horizontal reserved category had secured scores high enough to qualify without the vertical reservation, the person would be counted as qualifying without the vertical reservation and cannot be excluded from the horizontal quota in the general category. So past judgment based on the same case was similar question had arisen in the case of vertical reservation in the past. Rajesh Kumar Darya against Rajasthan Public Service Commission and other cases, and the law had been settled similarly. So what they said? If a person in the scheduled caste category secures a higher score than the cutoff for the general category, the person would be counted as having qualified under the general category instead of the scheduled caste quota. So what is the government stand in this whole episode? The government's policy was to restrict and contain reserved category candidates to their categories even when they had secured higher grades. The court said that this was tantamount to ensuring that the general category was reserved for upper caste. So the significance of this whole episode or the whole case is the ruling will give clarity on reservation and make it easier for governments to implement and apply reservation. More needy scheduled caste, scheduled tribes and other backward class candidates will be benefited if high scoring candidates are recruited under general category. So that's all for today's topic. We will meet you in the next topic. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.